I don't really love her. Yeah. I might have to double. Yeah. Dripping in my jealous. Yeah. Dripping in my jealous. Yeah. Dripping in my jealous.
The teacher has a chance again to teach a lesson. And their conscience to enhance. But what do you suppose a teacher has to do? He skips the lesson and makes us present a digital LEQ.
Topic was gender roles and family relations in East Asia and Sub-Saharan Africa. On the left, there is a graph of the distribution of households by person responsible for water collection. As shown in the graph, Sub-Saharan Africa and Asia both had women that were over 15 collecting the water. On the right, there is the graph of the contribution of family workers. And as you can see, women were in both regions were more responsible for working in the family. Our thesis believes that family and gender customs of East Asia and Sub-Saharan Africa are very similar. However, family was considered more important in Sub-Saharan Africa than in East Asia, as family rate decreased in China, and there were growing roles for women in Sub-Saharan Africa. Therefore, the family relations and gender roles of East Asia and Sub-Saharan Africa are more different than similar.
Similarities. Families took on, females took on jobs in the production industry such as pottery and textile work. Both East Asian and African men partake in polygamous marriages, and a family of females' responsibility was to develop a role as a caregiver due to their natural instances and differences. East Asia had a lack of family-oriented customs. The women were treated as servants towards their husbands and children. Furthermore, beauty customs decided their faith in society. In Africa, women were skilled in textile work, and marriage and family were more important to Africans as it was a sense of security.
Okay. Our big ideas for our topic were, how did the difference in family dynamics affect East Asia and Sub-Saharan Africa's treatment of women? And our second one was, why did customs set by society impact social interaction and serve as a aid for the women's rights movement?
So our evidence. So based on Confucian ideas, women were at the bottom of hierarchy. Records from 1868 to 1912 showed how women were responsible for committing themselves fully to the care of children and husband. Our first piece of evidence says women can be divorced for 7 reasons: irreverence to the husband's parents, impurity, laziness, barrenness, excessive talking, theft, and evil disease. Secondly, historians have extensively documented women's protests in pre-colonial and colonial periods and future recorded female involvement in anti-colonial struggles, liberation war, and nationalist political movements. And our evidence states, putting together the theoretical pieces of gender roles and social movements, not only to demonstrate how theories of social movements expand existing approaches to gender change, but also to show how attention and gender processes enlarges our understanding of women's collective action.
In conclusion, gender roles and familial relations were constant in both the East Asia and Sub-Saharan African regions. However, the two regions individually had their own customs. East Asia was a more strict society with set customs and roles for women in their hierarchy. Women's roles were solely to take care of the children and commit to their husband. In contrast, Sub-Saharan Africa had much more opportunities for women and leniency in their society. Women were more dominant in their jobs as they could become politicians and workers.
So here are a few pictures of So on the left, you can see in East Asia how the women were more prone to take care of the family. And on the right, in Sub-Saharan Africa, women were more involved in political movements.
This is our sourcing. Thank you.